I am Sunita. I am working as a biology teacher in KGBV Veragattam. Good morning, my young scientist. How are you? All of you follow the COVID precautions? Okay, very good. In previous class, we have already discussed about cell, the basic unit of life. Let us recall some information about cell. Who discovered that cell? Tell me that answer, you. Robert Hooke. Very good. Cell, the basic unit of life, because every organism life started with only one cell. All of you look at this. This is flowchart, picture type. All cells forms a tissues. All tissues forms an organs, and organs forms an organ system, and organs all organ systems forms an organism. So every organism life started with only one cell. So because cell the basic unit of life. Okay, understand? Now we are going on in this class. We discuss about cell, its structure and functions. What is our lesson name? Cell, its structure and function. All of you write down this heading in your first of all. Let us discuss about cell. Okay, every cell have three parts, that are cell membrane and nucleus and cytoplasm. A ball-like structure is called nucleus. This is the outer membrane of the cell, that is called cell membrane, and a fluid-like structure in the cell, that is called cytoplasm. Already we discussed that cell discovered Robert. First of all, we discuss about typical plant cell and typical animal cell. Let us we discuss typical plant cell. Okay, understand students? So plant cell have that cell wall, plasma membrane and cell membrane, and mitochondria, nucleus, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum and chloroplast, and that other one part is vacuoles. So these parts have plant cell. Okay, understand students? Very good. Next, let us discuss typical animal cell. Animal cell also have like these plant parts. Okay, big. All of you observe carefully. What are the main difference between these two cells? All of you observe that. All of you draw these circles in your notebook and write down differences between plant cell and animal cell. What are differences in plant cell? What are differences in animal cells? Animal cell in these two circuits, and some common features in this both cells that are right in this middle of the circuit. Okay, understand students? All of you draw these circles in your notebook. Let us we discuss one by one part in both cells. The first part, cell membrane. It works a gate of our house, because which material enter into cell and out of the cell. So this is the gate of the cell. It is the gate of our house. This cell membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. It gives support and protects to the cell. So this is the function of cell membrane. Okay, understand? The next part, cell wall. Okay students, the extra layer formed in the plant's outer layer of the cell membrane, that is called cell wall. Okay, this cell wall gives to support, protection, shape, structure gives to the cell. So this cell wall is only present in plant cell, not in animal cell. Okay, very good. So cell wall is only present in plant cell, absent in animal cell. All of you write the differences between already you are draw in your notebook. Okay, understand students? The next part, cytoplasm. Cyto means jelly, a fluid like structure in the cell that is called cytoplasm. Okay students, got it? So this cytoplasm have so many cell organelles and so many cell functions are done in here. Okay, this is about cytoplasm, and so many cell reactions are so many cell functions are in here. Okay, this is about cytoplasm. Students, let us discuss nucleus. Already we have learned about nucleus. Who discovered nucleus? Tell me that answer, you. Robert Brown. Okay, very good. This is the structure of nucleus. Nucleus have nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, nucleus, genetic material and nuclear pore. Okay, so nucleus have genetic information and all cells functions are controlled in this nucleus. So nucleus is called as control room of the cell. Okay, or the brain of the cell. Okay, understand students? Why the nucleus called as the cell control room? Because all cell functions are controlled in this nucleus. So nucleus called as the brain of the cell or cell's control room. Okay, got it? In the presence and absence of that nucleus, that cells are two types, that are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Okay, understand students? First of all, we discuss that prokaryotic cells. Cells do not have nucleus and nucleus membrane. That cells are called as prokaryotic cells. For example, bacteria, blue-green algae, that are. Okay, got students? That cells do not have nucleus and nucleus membrane. That are called prokaryotic cells. And that second one is eukaryotic cells. The cells have nucleus and nucleus membrane. That cells are called as eukaryotic cells. That example, plant cell and animal cell. We have already discussed about that. Okay, understand students? All of you draw these diagrams and write down this flowchart in your notebook. Okay students? Students, whatever we discussed till now, cell, plant cell, animal cell and cell membrane, cell wall, nucleus, cytoplasm. Okay, are you got it students? Okay, very good. Give two activities in our textbook. One of the cell membrane, how to observe cell membrane in onion peel and the mario leaf, and that second one is how to observe nucleus in cheek cell. After school reopening, we will do this activities. Okay students, already we have tell that names in plant and animal cell. So first of all, in this cell organelle, we discuss about the mitochondria. All of you look at, now we discuss mitochondria. This is one of the cell organelle. Mitochondria have two membranes, that is outer membrane and the inner membrane. So the inner membrane forms a folded like structures, that is called cristae. All of you observe this folded like structure in the inner part of the mitochondria, that is called cristae. In the between of the space of the cristae, a fluid like structure, that is called matrix. Okay, so mitochondria have outer membrane, inner membrane. That inner membrane forms a folded like structure, that is called cristae, and that space between the cristae is called that matrix. So this parts having mitochondria. Mitochondria are responsible for cellular respiration. So this is the main function of mitochondria. In this process, that glucose molecule break down and release some energy. So this the cause of mitochondria are called as powerhouses of the cell. Okay, this is examination oriented question. Why are called that mitochondria is powerhouses of the cell? Because it is responsible for cellular respiration and release some energy in this process. So mitochondria are called as powerhouses of the cell. All of you draw this diagram and the next cell organelles, plastids. These plastids are three types, that chromoplasts, leucoplasts and chloroplasts. Okay, how many types of plastids? Tell me that. Three types. Okay, very good. Sit down. So first of all, we discuss chromoplasts. So these are colored pigments. So in our daily life, we observe that tomatoes, green chilies are changes that green color into red color because of this pigments like chromoplasts. This is about chromoplasts. That second one is leucoplasts. These are colorless pigments. These leucoplasts are present in underground food materials like sweet potato, radish. Okay, this is about leucoplasts. And the third one is most important, that chloroplast. This is green in color. These chloroplasts present in green parts of the plants. Okay, got students? This is about plastids. Now we discuss about that important plastid, chloroplast. Okay, all of you write down this three types of plastids. Okay, okay. Chloroplasts are present in only in plant cells, not in animal cell. Okay, good. So chloroplasts have also two membranes, that are outer membrane and the inner membrane. Okay, that thylakoid structures are called grana, and sac-like structure presence in that chloroplast, that is called stroma. This grana is responsible for light reaction and stroma is responsible for dark reactions. So this is about the structure of chloroplasts. This chloroplast have outer membrane, inner membrane, and thylakoid structures are called as grana, and sac-like structure is called as stroma. This is the structure of chloroplasts. What is the function of chloroplast? The function of chloroplasts, it's trapped to sun energy or light energy, converted into chemical energy. It is helping for photosynthesis. So in this purpose, that chloroplast is called as food factory of the cell. Okay, got it, students? This is about chloroplast. All of you draw this diagram in your notebook and label these parts. The next cell organelle, ribosomes. Some granule-like structures floated in that cytoplasm, that are called ribosomes. All of you observe this. Some granules-like structure floated in this cytoplasm, that are called ribosomes. These ribosomes are two types, that are free ribosomes and attached ribosomes. So that free ribosomes are scattered in cytoplasm, and attached ribosomes are attached on the endoplasmic reticulum. So that are free ribosomes and attached ribosomes. The function of ribosomes is synthesis of proteins. So this is about ribosomes. Okay, understand, students? All of you draw this diagram in your notebook. Okay, the next cell organelle, endoplasmic reticulum, that shortcut name ER. So this endoplasmic reticulum is one network shape in the cell. That network membrane is known as endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, this endoplasmic reticulum are two types, that are rough endoplasmic reticulum RER, and that second one is soft endoplasmic reticulum, that is SER. First of all, we discussed that rough endoplasmic reticulum. That RER or rough endoplasmic reticulum have some granules like structure on their surface. Such parts are called as rough endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosomes attached on the surface of the ER, that ER is called as rough endoplasmic reticulum. Good. So, the function of rough endoplasmic reticulum, manufacture of proteins. So, that is the function of rough endoplasmic reticulum. And that second one is soft endoplasmic reticulum. This soft endoplasmic reticulum have not that ribosomes on that surface. So, that ER is called as soft endoplasmic reticulum. The function of soft endoplasmic reticulum, manufacture of fats. So, this is about endoplasmic reticulum. Stand up. How many types of ER? Two types. Very good. Next one, what are they? RER and SER. Okay, very good. Stand up. What are the function of soft endoplasmic reticulum? Manufacture of fats. Okay, good. So, this is about endoplasmic reticulum. All of you draw this diagram in your notebook. Let us discuss Golgi complex. These Golgi complex have the function of Golgi complex, transport two substances, one part to another. This is the function of Golgi complex. Okay, students. The next cell organelle, lysosome. This is single layer cell organelle. Okay, and this contains so many proteins and hydrolytic enzymes. If the cell damaged, the lysosomes burst and open. These result release that hydrolytic enzymes and dyes the cell. So that lysosomes are called as suicidal bags of the cell. Okay, understand students, this is about lysosomes. Lysosomes are called as suicidal bags of the cell. Okay, the next one, vacuole. The large empty spaces in the cell, that are called vacuoles. Okay, these vacuoles have nucleus, cytoplasm and this vacuole. These vacuoles are large size in plant cell. The function of vacuole, maintain pressure of the cell. So, this is the function of vacuole. This is about vacuole. All of you draw this diagram. Okay. Students, whatever we discussed till now, first of all, cell, plant cell, animal cell, cell membrane, cell wall, cytoplasm, nucleus, this is part of cell. That second part of cell organelles, mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, plastids, Golgi apparatus, vacuoles, this is. So, this is about cell organelles. Okay, all of you understand students? Okay, good. Now, we will discuss that cell theory. Cell theory formulated by Schleiden and Schwann. This cell theory have three important components. That one is Schleiden. All parts are made up of cells, and that Schwann, all animals are made up of cells. That last scientist discovered Rudolf Virchow, new cells are arranged from the pre-exiting cells. These three points are important components in the cell theory. So this is about our topic. Students, all of you write a table form in your notebook. In the first table form, cell part, and that second one is heading main function, and the third one nickname. All of you write down this three columns in your notebook. This is homework for you tomorrow. Okay, I will see compulsory on tomorrow. Okay students, all of you understand? Okay students, all of you look at these pictures once again. This is the flowchart of the cell. This is the structure of cell. Cell wall, cell membrane and cytoplasm. These are the parts in the cell. This is the typical plant cell and typical animal cell and nucleus. This is the one cell organelle, plastids. Okay students, okay, all of you draw this diagram in neatly. Next, these are cell organelles. All of you look at this students. This is mitochondria, chloroplast, ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, vacuoles, lysosomes. This is our last topic, cell theory. Okay students, understand all of you? Okay, all of you draw these diagrams and write the functions. Okay, good. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you so much.